Hi, welcome to Country Views. We have another special recipe today for you. I'm going to be making homemade pizza dough with the homemade pizza. So right now I'm going to start with the pizza dough. I'm going to make it from scratch. Right here I have Okay, guys, so it looks like my dough is ready. It is doubled in size. So over here, I have just my big cookie sheet. I have it greased with canola oil. It's important you grease it. It's going to help the dough rise even more. So I'm going to just take my dough out here. See how it has those air pockets in it? About using a cookie sheet, if your kids like the square size in pizza, you can cut it into square sizes. I mean, they love this stuff. My kids love the square sizes, and I tell you, they think they're getting more of a bite and more of the pizza when you cut it into square sizes. So that's just a little trick, you know, if you're a parent. Pockets in here for it to have room to rise. Okay. Hey guys, so I have all my stuff chopped up that I need. I have some jalapeno slices because we all love jalapeno. Although I'm only going to be doing half jalapeno today because my daughter doesn't feel like jalapenos today. I have some pepperoni. And I have some mozzarella cheese, okay? Now, I made my own sauce over here today. I'm gonna just show you. Okay, so you wanna do about 3 to 4 cans of tomato sauce. Some of this hot sauce, you can use Frank's or the Kroger brand. A cap full of canola oil, some chili sauce, and then you wanna use some garlic powder and some black pepper and a little salt. And then I also, in my pan before I added the sauce, if you want to get a good view of this for me, I sauteed some pickled onions and some regular onion in some butter, and then I added my sauce and Coney sauce to it. Okay, so now you're going to start with your sauce over here on your pizza dough. I have the pizza dough already. You're going to take this with your caramelized onions in it, And you're going to just dump the whole thing over your pizza, okay? What I like caramelizing the onions because I don't like a crunchy onion when I bite into it. So that's why I caramelize it. And then I add my sauce to it because I just think it's so yummy in the sauce. So you want to just add all that on there and you want to spread it on here evenly. Now this might be a knife and fork pizza, depending on how big your crust gets and depending on how much sauce you put on here. If you like it real saucy, it's definitely going to be a knife and fork pizza. If you like it with little salt, then it should be okay to just eat with your fingertips. So you spread all this goodness over this, like so. And you want to get even amounts on the whole pizza, okay? Like that. That's looking pretty yummy, isn't it, bub?
Yeah.
Okay, so according to how much cheese you want, little or a lot, we tend to like a lot of cheese. I'm going to start with this. And if I need more, I'm going to have my son get me some more. So you want to just spread it all around. I always start on the outsides because everybody forgets to put enough cheese on the outside. So I always make sure the outsides are coated first before I do the middle. And keep in mind too, you don't want to overpower the cheese because you are going to be putting veggies and stuff on it. Okay, looks like this might be enough cheese today, bub. What do you think?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? It's looking pretty cheesy, isn't it? A little more cheese there in the middle, a little bit more over here. And mozzarella cheese does get real stringy, so unless you like extra cheese. But that's about the perfect amount of cheese that you're going to do. Now, over here, I have my pepperoni, my jalapenos. I'm going to take my pepperoni and come over here. And I'm going to just break it apart and start putting it on here evenly. Okay. And one package of pepperoni should be enough unless you're like a super pepperoni person, which we usually are, but with all the other good toppings on here, you really don't need more than one package. So you want to just keep assembling this pepperoni on here. Okay? It shouldn't take too much longer. It doesn't really take a long time to put your pepperoni on. So we're just going to put this on really quickly so we can get this popped in the oven after we put our jalapenos on. Pepperonis left, so that's when we just put a bite in our mouth of our pepperoni, good old pepperoni. Oh, there's still some more left, so let's just add it on. We'll just throw it on here, spread it all out. I chopped them up myself. Be sure to wash your hands really well after handling these because you will burn your eyes if you rub your eyes. So I'm just going to do half of the pizza and the jalapenos. That way you have variety. Whoever don't want it, whoever does want it, there's half and half. Okay? Okay guys, so that's what your half and half pepperoni pizza looks like right here. You can get a good view of that. All right. So I'm going to open my oven up here, and I'm going to pop my pizza in. Now, I've had my oven heating on 450 degrees. You want to put it on your top rack, and you're going to bake it for 15 to 20 minutes, depending on how your dough rises and how your cheese looks. You want a little bit of a golden brown on your cheese, but you don't want to burn it, okay? Mozzarella burns very, very easy. So when this gets done, we'll be back and I will show you the finished product and we will have a taste test. Okay guys, so the pizza's done. This is what it looks like. Doesn't that look ooey gooey and cheesy? The crust, this is about what consistency you want on your crust. It looks really, really good. Sometimes you want to let it cool a little bit, but I'm going to go ahead and cut a little piece of each so you can see us try it. And that way you can see how gooey gooey it is. So I'm just going to cut a little piece here of each side, okay? Where's that pot holder here? Be very, very careful, guys. This is very hot. Okay? Look how gooey that cheese is. That's why sometimes it's good to let it just sit, okay? But you want to cut them in about this size of squares. It's so much easier if you have a pizza cutter. I don't have one, so I'm using my sharp knife here. Sometimes your cheese will want to fall off, so you gotta figure out what direction you're going here, okay? Jalapeno here so you can see. Okay. Alright. If your cheese starts to come up, just pat it back down. Alright, are you ready for this, bub?
Yeah.
I'm gonna feed you bites since you're running the camera, okay? Look at that, guys. The cheese has just fallen off. And then here's our piece of jalapeno. Better grab it from this end. Look at that, guys. Yum, yum, yum. All right, bub, are you ready for a bite of this good pizza? All right, let's back up here and I'm gonna just cut some bites out of here. Let's get our cat off the counter. I'll grab them down. All right. Have a little technical difficulty here. You know how it is when you got animals, guys. So I'm just gonna cut him a bite of each here. Look at that. Give him a nice bite with the jalapeno on it. All right, let's start with this. Let's get you your cheese that fell off here. That's really hot. So let me blow on it for you. You see that, guys? Look at all that cheese. Okay. That's the pepperoni one. What do you think? Is that good with them caramelized onions and coney sauce? All right, are you ready for a bite of the jalapeno side? Maybe we should cut this bite a little smaller, considering it might be hot. Look how saucy it is too, you guys. Look at that. There's the jalapeno one. How is that? A little hot bite? Is it good though with the jalapeno? Good. All right, so I'm gonna try a bite here. Just so y'all can see that I eat pizza too. Oh man, that's delicious. All right guys, well thank you for visiting Country Views. And we'll be uploading some more videos daily, Monday through Friday. We won't be uploading on the weekends. But I want you to have a great day. Bye.